rush. Right.
Welcome back to another episode of the Remote Revolution Show. Good to see you, James.
Welcome, George.
Nice to see you,
That's
man.
That's a lovely
nice
handshake.
Fantastic. Yeah. So today, we're going to talk about how to start an online fitness business.
Oh.
How to actually start one. How we're going to talk about James's story and how he actually started one. We've done another podcast on this in the past, talking about James's story of actually building an online business. But really what we wanted to dive into today in more detail, a lot of teasing in that sentence.
That was a lot for you, man.
Yeah, it was a lot of tease. But we got there. The detail we want to go into is how to actually get things started. What does it actually look like to be coaching clients online? How do we build this? How do we start this? What do we need in our head?
And how do we do it the right way? I think that's really important, because the chances are you're watching this video because you've already started and things aren't moving as quickly as you wanted, or you're overwhelmed by all the information which is out on the Google machine right now. And you're like, well, what is actually right and what is wrong? And we want to show you what's proven. Yeah. And we want to tell you the truth, what I actually did to take my business, my nutrition business, my nutrition and fitness business from zero to six figures in under a year back in 2015. So we've been in the game for quite a while. We've now helped hundreds and hundreds of students do the same thing. We've been through it. Hopefully this is going to be a great episode for you, and you can finally stop scrolling Google and you'll have a game plan to work from.
Yeah, let's go.
Hang on. No, before they go, you need to like the video.
Yes. Like the video. Subscribe to this channel if you want to hear more tips and tricks. It's not really tips and tricks, is it? It's a bit in detail breakdowns of how things work from these lovely gentlemen here.
And you got to ring the bell if we didn't say that.
Yeah, ring that bell.
You've got to ring that bell, get notifications. And also, before we get too deep into this, at any point, if you're like, I love this content, this is amazing, and I want more information, just check out the show notes down below, because there's some amazing free material that you can get your hands on to take everything we talk about today to a deeper level. So check those out as well.
Absolutely. And drop us a comment. Let us know what you liked about this, what you didn't like about this, and how we can help you further. Like, the feedback is important. If we don't get the feedback, we can't help you the way you need it.
I'll give you some feedback. Your arm's looking great today. Maybe it's the lighting, or you've just worked out. Just a compliment. I'm giving you feedback.
Thank you. I appreciate that. I think a combination of the lighting, the workout, and just generally making some gains, mate. You know how it is.
Vegan lifestyle as well, mate.
That's it, mate. There's a secret to that.
Hate down below. Okay, let's go.
Right. So, nice. Got that. So, yeah, we want to talk about your story, but we wanted to introduce Tom Frierson.
This is good.
Who's been making some huge momentum in his online fitness business. So he started his online fitness business, and one of the things we're going to talk about today is a little hint here.
If we're going to say Hitler then.
A little hint. He's having a process. It's having a process. That is one of the key things to actually starting an online fitness business. And Tom was talking about today, huge win yesterday, 4.6K in one sale from a complete stranger that came to him. Right, and he was able to close that by having a specific process to follow. Right, he later says, so a lady saw him in Hyde Park, blah blah blah. She googled his business, contacted me for a call, so on and so on and so on. Using the OSA training, I went down the discovery route, something I didn't do in the past for PT calls, as I have zero idea it existed, and worked out very quickly she would hit all of the 10 certainties. Something we talk about in a previous episode, it is staging the sale. That is what that podcast is about. So he pitched it, and he got signed up as a client for £4,600.
Online, going from in-person PT, training people in a park, to now training people from the comfort of your own home.
Yeah.
And it can really happen that quickly. This was literally in a matter, I think, of days, if not weeks, of jumping on board online and having a system to follow. And it can be that quick for you, but you must have a process. So that being said, let's talk about processes and let's talk about my journey. I think you want to...
Yeah, well, I want to ultimately extract from James. Like, we've heard James's story before, and I want to kind of go through that a little bit again, because there's some important foundations there. But I really want to extract from James today, like, how did he coach his clients? So many people, when they want to start online, they want to know, how do I actually coach people online? So I'm going to get the details for you today from this gentleman over here. And
Gentleman.
Wow, and
I feel privileged.
And then we're going to break that down and talk about what actually you need to do in this day and age, and how things are a little bit different now, because, you know, you're so old and that was so long ago.
I am so old, mate. I have wrinkles. It hurts to get up in the morning.
Fucking hell.
It's happening to you, mate. He's a baby. You're 27?
Baby, mate.
No, I'm pushing the 30s now.
I'm not even a quarter way through my life yet.
Congratulations. You might not even be a tenth of the way through.
Yeah. I might live till 270.
That would be a tenth, yeah. Anyway, we're going off track. Let's get back to the show.
You know, everything started from you. You were in corporate job.
Yeah, mate.
In London?
Yeah.
Living the dream?
Nope.
What you'd worked so hard for university?
Nope.
And you were a level 3 qualified PT. You had your Wix website. You were also a BTN, been through BTN Academy, had the nutrition qualification. Yep. How many clients did you have?
I had 3 clients at the point of deciding I wanted to quit my job. Here's the thing. I knew I wanted to get into health and fitness. I had stumbled across the power of it myself and seen how my body had changed and my dad had been on his own journey and his health had deteriorated. And I was like, I have this skill. I must share it with people. Yeah. Maybe that's how you feel as well. Maybe you're in a corporate job or you're stuck on the gym floor. You can probably relate to this. I was like, I want to get this into more hands. So I started to build a Wix website thinking that's what you do to have an online business. To have an online business, you need a website. That means you have a business. So I did that and I spent a ridiculous amount of time. I literally mean every night I'd get home from work and for an hour, just like, move boxes around on this drag and drop Wix thing. And I just thought the prettier I made it, the more clients I would get.
Yes.
That's pretty much what I was
thinking. What else were you doing? You were doing blogs, weren't you?
I was doing blogs. I was pretty much writing a blog once or twice a week. I read somewhere an article like, blogs are the way. So I'd be writing these blogs, trying to do SEO.
In fairness, at the time, blogs were still a really good tool to use. Yeah. But this is tactical. This was a tactical piece.
Yeah. But I had my messaging was so off because I was just like, I was reading like these scientific blogs and I'm like, this is definitely what my audience want to hear. And I'm like, in hindsight, no, your audience are not you. If they were you, they wouldn't need your help.
I'm curious, did you think about it as an audience then?
No. I'm just using the language that I'm using today. Like,
how did you like, why were you writing people, blogs? What were your expectations?
I just wanted people to read and become educated and to become, you know, knowledgeable on what I had learned. But it was right. The stuff I was writing was just, you know, I'm talking about specific micronutrients and nutrient timing and stuff like that. It's just so irrelevant for the 99% of the population yeah. that I could have worked with. Anyway, so you asked me how many clients I have. I had 3 clients and they were paying me £40 a month at the time.
About $50.
They were on my silver program.
Oh.
I had a bronze, silver and gold program.
Of course you did.
They were laid out nicely on the website.
Yeah.
And they all opted for the silver. And that was what was happening. And I remember at the time I was in corporate. I was probably earning around £2,000 a month in corporate after tax and stuff. And I was like, how on earth am I going to get enough clients to replace this income? I was
like, 50 clients?
Yeah, exactly. I was like, how? Like, and I was so stuck and in this space. And I remember being like, I need to find a way. So I went to Google and I remember searching like online fitness business or making money online. And I ended up going to this website called The Fitpreneurs, which was a coaching company at the time. And then I found out they had a podcast. So I started listening to their podcast and on the way to work every day in my car, I was driving down the M1 on the way to London and I'd listen to the podcast and I was getting inspired like, hang on, if what they're saying is true and I can truly close online clients for $1,000 or £1,000, now I only need 2 of those to quit my in-person job and go online. I can surely get 2 clients. And I started to understand more about marketing and things like that. And I got to a point where I was like, okay, this seems awesome. And I eventually ended up going to an event. I went to an event. I paid £500 for a ticket to go. It was a 3-day event. And I got more details on how this program worked, how the process worked. And it gave me the confidence to be like, do you know what? Screw it. I'm going to get my credit card out. I'm going to go all in on this. And I put all the money on a credit card, quit my job the next sort of day effectively, broke up with my girlfriend and went all in on this idea of building an online business. I was so inspired by that event and the belief that my dream can become a reality if I have the right people around me. Yeah, that's what happened.
A couple of really important things to share here. Like, if you've not picked this up from what James is saying here, like, you have to get excited. If you want to start a business, like, imagine a train. That is your business. That is a successful business. But it's only a successful business when it's a certain way down the fucking train track. And your job in starting a business is moving that train. You, physically, on your own, have to start pushing the train and push it down the train tracks. That is a insanely difficult thing to do if you are not excited, not motivated, not ready to like go out, like make it happen, right? If you're not got the Eddie Hall kind of focus and intensity, probably Eddie Hall would be able to do it, but
yeah. That's true, mate. Probably just pull it down the track. But the point is you have to be a person who is waking up every day thinking about this, going to bed every night thinking about this. It has to preoccupy every waking moment. And if it's not, then don't build an online business. Don't build a business.
Yeah.
Like, it's not for you. I promise you, the challenges that you're going to encounter along that road, along that train track, are huge. They're momentous. You can't possibly imagine them. And the only way to get around them is to be committed to the game of building that business.
Yeah. We've got some clients and some of our clients, like, I'm not going to speak badly about them, but they're not like the brightest people we've ever worked with.
Yeah.
Like some of those clients, but they're so excited about their business. They're more successful than some of the smartest people we've had. You know, some doctors that even come in, they're more successful than the doctors.
Yeah.
They're less educated than the doctors and all that, but they're so excited and passionate about what they're doing. They're able to use that energy and drive it into the business. And You know, we could talk about this for days, but ultimately here, the key point is that James was able to, he was able to put himself in an environment that allowed him to be excited. You're already excited because of the situation you were in. You know, you had made a transformation in your life. Obviously, your dad's health was deteriorating, and then you were able to, like, really make things, you're passionate about making things happen. So after this event, you had some tactics, you had some tools, you had things you could now implement.
Yeah, so I went to the event and obviously I signed up to this program. I think it was $8,000 is what I paid for the program. Yep. And one of the first things that I was told to do was to get on Facebook and start producing content, which, like, I was doing blogs before, and I was might have been doing, I think I was just sharing my blog on Facebook, that old share button.
Oh, the strong.
Yeah, which does nothing, by the way, if you're just sharing posts like from somewhere else on your wall. Pointless. You need natural organic content that you're writing purposely for the platform. And the best way of doing that is to get your phone out and do the most uncomfortable thing, which is a Facebook Live, because people get to know you on a live video. Like, there's no filter. There's nothing stopping you. So I was tasked with this 7-day Facebook Live challenge. And every day for 7 days, I'd have to go on and do a Facebook Live and just talk about what I was doing, like what my beliefs were, what the program was going to be like, and like all these ideas. And people would comment, they'd engage, I'd get a load of hate, which was really disheartening, but I had to deal with that. And I got through it and I started messaging the people who were engaging on my video. If it was a like, if it was a little love heart, if it was a comment, I'd engage and I'd message them. And then within 3 days, I remember, I think it was my first sales call. I jumped on and I sold a program for 12 weeks for £997, about $1,200. And that was my first ever high ticket sale. And I remember hanging up the phone and screaming and running downstairs. My dad was on a phone call downstairs. So I ran back upstairs where my mum and my sister were in my sister's bedroom. And I tried to barge in and they were on a phone call speaking to someone else as well. And I was like, no, I've got no one to share this with. But I was so amped. I was like, I cannot believe this is real. And then afterwards, I finally talked to them all and they were like, wow, it's amazing. It's amazing. And it just suddenly became like, holy moly, like 3 days into this, I can do this.
This is real. This is possible. And that's huge. Having that belief that I can do this, you have to get that as soon as possible. You have to get this excitement. You have to start creating movement to build momentum, and you keep that momentum by believing that it is possible down the road. A huge proponent of that is to get someone to show you the path.
Yeah.
You were able to, you know, follow a process.
Multiple processes.
You were held accountable to you know, doing this 7-day thing. You had a process for making sales.
Let's back up here. Here's what happened. So I was shit scared to do a Facebook Live. Right. What allowed me to do it was seeing other people in the group on the mentorship program doing it. And I had a process to follow for it, like you said. Then I started getting hate on the Facebook Live. And I remember having a coaching call the next day, like a weekly coaching call. And my coach going through the mindset piece of me, making me aware that people are just trying to pull me down to their level. And you're trying to do something that's different from the norm. And naturally people are going to feel offended by that. Yeah. And their reaction is to pull you down. So if I wouldn't have had that support, then I probably would have stopped doing the Facebook Lives. And then obviously I then had a sales script to follow, which in the early days, you must know what questions to ask on a sales call. Like, so many fit pros fall into this mistake where they're just like, they're probably just asking like, what's the goal that someone wants? Okay, here's your nutrition plan that you're going to follow. Here's what we're going to do. Your trainer, just telling them things. It's not what sells a high ticket program. Like, if you want to really create a successful online business, you need to understand like emotionally what is going through your audience's mind by asking the right questions. So I learned how to ask powerful questions on a sales situation. So I had all these processes. I had this support network, and that meant that I felt confident in what I was doing. And if you, again, like if you're not confident in what you're doing, you don't believe you can get results for someone, they're never gonna buy a high ticket program from you. Because ultimately, if you look at any sales environment, people buy from the most confident party. That's what it is. So if you are more confident than they are in their ability to not get results, and you're more confident in their ability to get results, they're eventually gonna lean towards you. The person with the highest certainty will win. Like all those things, plus my obsession with Tony Robbins as well, like just understanding mindset and
That helped.
Being a positive person, it just meant that my certainty was so high. When I was talking to these people on the phone for the first time, they were like, who is this guy? Who's this ball of energy? I want to be around that. And all of those factors just meant that I could close that sale in 3 days. And like the rest is pretty much history.
I mean, of course, we're going to be here saying that, hey, you should get a mentor. But like we've both done that. We practice what we preach. But here's the other thing. Like we live in a day and age where you can get information from other people like that. And sometimes, you know, paying a good amount of money to get that information is very much worth it in this current world that we live in. Like it's there, you can pay for it. And the return on investment that you're going to get from paying for information like that and coaching and support is just crazy.
Yeah, but the key is it's not just information, because you can get information for free. It's having systemized information in a sequential order. Like a proven process with accountability to deliver that information.
Yeah.
big difference between the
obviously,
two.
Obviously, we're very passionate about this, so we'll move on. But like, this is what we have found has allowed people to, hundreds of people that we've helped get become successful, and we've seen many other people do it through other programs as well. But like, that's why this stuff exists, and it's super important. So we had a lot of systems. You started getting clients online. A lot of people, we're going to talk a little bit more about sales in a minute, but a lot of people right now will be asking like, how did you coach clients though? Like, how did you actually get results for clients that were paying you £1,000? How can you get results for clients that are paying you, you know, £2,000, £3,000, which we will definitely talk about or have talked about many times.
Yeah, like Tom, 4.6K.
Yeah. So what were you doing to coach clients?
Well, this is 2015, 2016. So it's a different time. We didn't have the wide array of applications that are available today.
Yeah, there's like a lot of nice stuff now.
It's become, like, everyone knows what Zoom is. Everyone knows how to do a video call now.
Hey, I disagree. Some of you might not know what Zoom is.
But the overwhelming majority of people, especially with what's happened in...
More people will know, for sure.
So back then, there's me trying to figure out how to... I used to be doing sales calls and trying to get people to sign up to Skype and like send really complex... It was a nightmare. It was a nightmare back then. So we had all these hurdles. Yep. And one of those hurdles was delivering a program. So I was figuring a lot of this stuff out. And I was like, how am I going to deliver a workout to someone online? And I remember when I went to my local gym when I was 14 with my rugby club, we got these Excel spreadsheets printed out being like, here's for chest day, you got inclined dumbbell press, flat bench press, you'd have all these things, and then here's your reps and sets, and you'd write in the boxes. I was like, yep, I'll just make spreadsheets for people and send them to people. And I think I used Dropbox or something at the time. And I was like, I'll just send people these spreadsheets and they'll have to complete them and send them back to me so I could see their workouts. And that was literally how I got people to do the workouts. And then I hyperlinked the workout name, so like inclined dumbbell chest press. I would go to YouTube, I'd find a decent video of someone doing it, hyperlink it so they could go watch it. I didn't do it myself. I was like, there's no way I'm going to go to the gym and film 150 videos of all these exercises. That's not worth my time. And I think a lot of people fall into that trap when they're building a business. They're like, it must be me in this. I must have a membership site. I must have perfect everything. It's like, no, you need to make cash. Cash is oxygen in your business. You can figure the rest of the stuff out along the way. What matters is making cash and getting results. And honestly, it doesn't matter if it's you in the video or somebody else. Like, that's just your ego. Yeah. As long as it teaches them how to do the movement, that's awesome. Let's crack on. So that was the first thing, spreadsheet.
Yeah, and there's videos online, right? People have... There is YouTubers online that make shitloads of cash from making high quality, incredible looking YouTube videos. You do not have that much money to make nice videos.
just hyperlink them. Just,
yeah. And the cool thing is, like with like PT Distinction and
Trainerize
and things like that, like
True Coach,
they all have videos within them now.
Yeah. And before you write down which is the best one, it's like, what's the best car? Do I get an Audi, a BMW, or a Mercedes? Like, they're all great cars. They're all great. Like, all the big software providers, they're great.
Yeah.
So you have that feature now where you don't need to make a spreadsheet. You can have an online app, which solves a lot of things.
We're big fans of PT Distinction. Highly recommend you go check them out. Yep. So there we go. The next piece.
Nutrition. Much bigger thing. So again, I went through BTN Academy, which is a nutrition provider in the UK. So I was qualified. There's tons of providers. I was personally very interested in my own nutrition. Found out about MyFitnessPal. This was when it was super clunky, super ugly. It used to be so bad.
Yeah.
So bad. And I used to track all my macros and stuff in that. When I used to go to work, my food in Tupperwares. And I remember like tracking it all in MyFitnessPal. Everyone at work was like, you freak, what are you doing?
Yes.
It's probably a different world now, but I was doing that. And I was like, well, if I can get my clients to use MyFitnessPal, that would be great too. But again, I was like, how am I going to find out if they're doing the right thing or not? So I just dug around in MyFitnessPal for ages and realized that you could add friends. And then for some friends, you could make them private friends where they could see your diary. So then I was like, all my clients that I came on, I was like, add me as a friend. Make sure your MyFitnessPal log is visible to me and I'll be able to check your nutrition. So I would just check that every day. At the end of the day, I'll just check their nutrition, see they've done it, drop them an email if they hadn't. It really was that simple. But again, like today, you have software that will do all this for you.
Yeah, pretty much. And then the next thing that you did was supply them with a coaching call.
Yeah.
So like whenever you're trying to move something online, we always think about this, like we've got a huge team on, well, not a huge team, but we're building a team online and we're always trying to think about how to interact with our team as if we're in an office. So like if you're coaching a client, you know, and you're going to give them and you help them with their nutrition, help them with the training, how can you transfer that to online? How else can you get that same information to them and help them with it in an online format? And just trying to bridge that gap and solve that problem. And one of the things that you do when you're in person is obviously you're speaking to your client, you're helping them out. You probably got a bit of time before and after the session to do some coaching, kind of helping them with their mindset. Maybe they're helping them out with the understanding what they need to focus on nutritionally, or maybe that's purely what you do. And it's amazing, you know, there's this thing called Zoom. There's actually about 9,000 different applications to call someone now. You can simply phone call them, FaceTime, WhatsApp,
yeah, is it
Facebook,
endless. Anyway, but this is it. Like, you will know if you're a personal trainer right now in a gym, you spend the majority of your time talking to your client about what's going on in their personal life, what's going on with their family. Like, you talk about all these things. And I was like, I need to make sure they have an outlet for that as an online client. So I basically just took those conversations and had it as an online catch up. We talk about the nutrition that week, their training that week, we make amendments to the plan, I tell them what amendments we're making, and then we just check in and make sure they're doing well, they're happy with the program.
Yeah.
What else can I do to support you? We'd ask questions like that and continue to give us good service. So that was it. And one of the things that we didn't mention is when I brought someone to the program, we would have an initial assessment form, which I got from BTN Academy, which was like how to assess someone when they come on board. And you might have done that as an in-person PT right now, or maybe as a nutrition coach yourself. So I just had that as a Survey Monkey. That's what we used back then. You can use Jot Form, Survey Monkey, Type Form. There's Google Forms. There's tons of form providers.
Forms.
Endless. Again, doesn't matter. Go and grab something. And then I got that out to people. I'd look at their forms and then we'd have an initial coaching call. We'd set out the plan together and I'd build out their plan. I'd build out that spreadsheet. I'd get them my fitness power up and running. And eventually it got to a point where people were like, do I get a meal plan? Do I get like anything? And I was proper into food back then. I had a company called Naked Nutrition. It was about nutrition and cooking and stuff like that. So I was really into trying to make healthy food. So I'd always look at recipes from Ramsay or Gordon Ramsay, Jamie Oliver, whoever it was, and be like, how do I make this healthier? How do I make it less calories, basically? So I'd make all these modified recipes and then I would go to Canva. I would get my recipe book out. I'd change the recipe so it was slightly different because I'd obviously changed it. I'd type it up on Canva and I just ended up accruing all these recipes over time. And I ended up with far too many recipes. I ended up with hundreds. I didn't need to make hundreds, but I went down this pathway. And then I'd send those people when they joined the program. I'd be like, what food are you interested in? And I'd be like, oh yeah, I've got a curry. Oh yeah, I've got a chili. Oh yeah, I've got whatever. And I'd be like, I've got some healthy versions. And then I'd build them into a simple meal planner on literally a Google Word document, not Google, Microsoft Word document. And I'd have that document for people. And they'd be able to be like, Monday, I'm having this meal. Tuesday, I'm having this meal. And I'd just link it all up for people. So basic. And then people would follow it. And that was it.
There you go. And again, there's now an application that will basically do all of that for you. Basically, the best thing that you can do when it comes to coaching clients, if using an application and technology is a proper pain in the ass for you, then something like this might be what you need to do. But it's kind of worth, you know, spending 2-3 hours kind of going through. The cool thing with applications now is they have a whole training section. I know PT Distinction has a whole section on educating yourself and how to actually use the platform. It's really direct, it's really straightforward, and it's awesome. So like using stuff like that, going through that, spending a few hours, just kind of understanding what you need to know is going to help you move forward. And I mean, the main thing when it comes to coaching clients, like what's going to help someone get a result in their health and fitness? 3 things, nutrition, training, and mindset. So if you give them a nutrition plan, you give them a training plan, and then you hold them accountable using coaching calls and a check-in software that you're going to use, that's how you're going to get results online. That's how you can coach people online as a fitness trainer, as a personal trainer, as a nutrition coach.
Some things we just want to hit on before we wrap this up.
To wrap this up, you can't deliver any of this. You can't deliver those results to anyone if you don't have any clients. This is a key point that we must say, right? You've got to realize when you're starting an online fitness business or any business in general that is a client-based business, you need clients. you need clients. You don't need a fancy program. You don't need to spend hours like weeks and weeks on these softwares, which you can do. And we're trying to encourage you not to get carried away with that, because we certainly have done in the past and it was a complete waste of time.
Do you remember when we sat in Bali and we were building out like funnels with ClickFunnels and building out money chat?
We
would spend days
not
trying to get clients, just trying to build this thing, and that one day someone would come across our website and buy it. It's lunacy. It's a shop in a desert is what it's analogous to.
It was awful. You must learn how to sell. And at the very least, get a sales script.
Please get a sales script.
Get a process to follow. And like, if our podcasts are not going to help you with that, then like they should. If that's not enough for you still, then go check out the show notes. You can jump on our free crash course. We have a whole crash course that's going to take you through this stuff. And of course, you can get in touch with our team and again, talk through this with our team as well. That's really the key thing that allowed you to propel forward. Like, you had all these bits and pieces that you were really passionate about, coaching and nutrition and training, but until you actually had those sales systems, and you weren't a salesperson.
Not a salesperson. I'd never done sales ever in my life. I was passionate about nutrition and training, and that passion carries you such a long way. And then I just surrounded myself with some basic sales principles, the scripts that I had, and also binging Tony Robbins, which is all psychology, which is essentially communication, which is sales.
Yeah.
So I was every day just watching Tony Robbins on YouTube.
I remember you saying that if you can just get in front of people, you can pitch them on your offer.
That was it.
On getting on having a conversation about
I was going to fitness. All the local businesses. I was getting in there, being like, hey, can I put an event on for your clients? Like nail bars, runners clubs, like tennis clubs. Be like, can I just put an event on for your guys? Like, let's do it one evening. And I was just putting myself out there relentlessly. And I was effectively using offline marketing, putting myself in front of people to sell an online program. That is what I was doing. And you can do the exact same thing. Like, again, the most uncomfortable thing is the thing that you're going to get the most reward from. And I was just willing to get uncomfortable because I was like, I quit my job. I'm passionate about this. I want to help people. I'm going all in. And it was that simple. And you can honestly do it too. And like George says, there's so many resources for you down below this video. So if you are watching this right now, our crash course is amazing. We'll show you how to get your first client in 5 days. So jump aboard that. And if you want to get a fast track and you want to get our team to support you and get a mentor to really support you long term, then there's an option for that down below as well. So check out those links. And if you have any questions, let us know in the comments below.
Yeah, indeed. Thank you for watching, guys. Hope this was helpful.
We'll see you soon.
See you soon. Peace.